Yeah, so Doc, no? I just wanted to ask you specifically about Typhoon Karina kasi yan ang recent experience ng maraming tao. At in the wake of that disaster, ang daming mga factors nga yung nabanggit, no? Yung pangulo mismo, no, nabanggit niya climate change, ang basura, yung ibang tao naman, pati mga senador, no, sinasabi malaking factor itong reclamation project sa Manila Bay. Ang daming nagtuturoan, pasaway kasi mga tao, nabanggit nyo rin yung basura, and then nabanggit nyo rin yung master planning. Sabi ng iba, wala nga master plan, puro mga maliliit na projects. And of course, there's the issue of deforestation at kulang sa reforestation. How do these fit together? No? Ano yung pinakamalaking factor? Kasi given na yung low-lying tayo, no? Given na yan, di naman pwedeng... evacuate yung Metro Manila, nandiyan na yan, no? So what's the best way of adapting, no? Should we, for example, stop the reclamation projects?
Your reclamation was a different story, but when you look at flood control, definitely you have to start from the headwaters, so uplands, watersheds, all the way down. Now that's what we always say, holistic approach to flood risk management. Now, one of the things that really reduces the capacity of the rivers, yung sediments. So how do you control sediments? But upstream ba, meron ka ng mga control, maybe you have forest that will minimize yung sediment yield from the watersheds and then gets into your river. It then shallows the river. Imagine during Typhoon Ondoy, that area in Loyola Granvilla, there was a Tumane Bridge there. And if you're aware of that, that crosses yung from Loyola Granvilla, Jens Balara. You go down there and then you go across to San Mateo or Marikina, no? Tumane. That is an overflow bridge. So nakakadaan doon on top, meron kang concrete, patas meron culvert sa bottom, and then pag mataas ang tubig, tatapon lang doon. So hindi pwedeng dumaan. But during Ondoy, it must have been filled up mga 2 to 3 meters of sediment over a period of mga 7 hours. So imagine mo, that area, syempre, na-bury siya, 2 to 3 meters. But think along the river, 2 to 3 meters nawala yung depth na yun. So it will reduce that so much capacity. So that's one. So that's why you have to have controls upstream.
Excuse me, Doc. Saan naman nang galing yung sediment na nagbara ng ilog? Dahil ba walang puno sa gubat?
That's one. Because if you are really a lot of rain, mahirap i-control yung sediment na mag-erode from your watersheds. Archipelagic countries, ganun talaga ang problema. Either you're quarrying along the river banks and so on, but the bulk of the sediment comes from the yung overland flow plains na watersheds, no? I mean, not in the river, but on the sides, you know? So, because you just have so much rain. We're talking about humid tropic rains, which are like 400, 500 millimeters in one day. That's a lot of rain, you know, if you think about it. Anyway, so you go down to the downstream. So napuno ng sediment and nawala na yung capacity river mo. Now you also have some debris coming from the mountains. Maybe mga logs or maybe some of these na-uprooted na mga vegetation, they will also contribute to, we call it a creates roughness or friction, vale? Because you have these mga roughness elements and so on. So those are things. Now, if you think about those kinds of rains na na-experience natin, Ondoy, Karina, Ulysses, yung Habagat or yung sudden onset ng mga typhoons na storms, it's just so much rain that we are experiencing, vale? So it's not quite easy to control that. As far as that's the problem. You can do this, but one of the things that I've noticed in the Philippines, and that's where we don't really have a dedicated body to look at this flood risk management or flood planning or adaptive planning for flood control on a daily basis? Or when I say daily, it's like maybe you do a study every day, but good for the next 3 months or 6 months. Because a year ago, ito na nga nangyari. And if you look at Metro Manila, you have different sub-basins or where you have Marikina, Tulyahan, nandun sa Sapote, Bacoor, and those areas, you have to, as an academic ballet, you have to run simulation models. Different scenarios, you change the land use, what will happen. If you do this kind of a structural measure or non-structural measures, what happens? Will it work? Maybe it works here, but doesn't work another place. And then you think in terms of floods na generating mechanism. Typhoons are so much different from habagat. In fact, if you look at the master plan na ginawa noong 2010, World Bank yung nag-fund on, all the design flood parameters, we call it, based on a two-day rainfall, based on a 1:50, 1:100, like one shot over the next 2 days. But we can have multiple peaks in our floods, our rain, and then it can even last for 5 days. Like the Habagat of 2012, August, that was 7 days, ulan na ulan. Mahina yung intensity, pero over 7 days, you have more than what you got from Undoy or Ulysses. Same thing with Carina. You get in 3 days' time, you get more than what was what fell during Undoy over almost 24 hours. 455 yung Undoy 24 hours. Carina about 600 over almost 3 days. Almost 65 hours.